We've come a long way now. We're at the stage in which we have a model implemented. We've done our sanity checks. It's time now to be a little bit more formal about model evaluation. So let's take a recap of what we've learned so far. We've seen that the model does qualitatively produce illusions. Here, for the perceived world motion, we have a tight cluster near the actual world motion, but there's also cases in which your self-motion is occurring in your world motion. So the mix of the blue and the red is showing that our illusion occurs. Near the self-motion, though, we see this very elongated scatter, which isn't exactly like what we're seeing in our participant data. This elongated scatter is arising from two sources. The vestibular motion signals are very noisy, and when the self-motion is detected, that perceived self-motion is algebraically integrated into the world motion magnitudes. This simple modeling trick is now doing something which doesn't exactly mirror the participant's judgments. So let's try to quantify this now and see what we can do. Quantification is a step that we call model evaluation. We try to answer the questions, does the model interface with the data? Does the model capture the data? Does it do better or worse than other models that we might have for the data? And does the model provide insights that are not directly accessible from the data alone? In order to verify how well a model captures the data, one of the simplest and gold standard tricks is to simply plot your predictions against the observations. The beauty of this is that the graph that's ideal is always just a straight line with unit slope. So it becomes very easy to see whether or not your model is producing quantitatively what it should be. We can quantify the relationship, the deviation away from the ideal situation of a predicted versus actual unit slope. And there are many different ways to do this. Here, what we'll do is compute the variance explained, or the R squared. But in general, there are better ways that you'll learn about throughout the NMA Academy using machine learning and other techniques to quantify these relationships in also a gold standard quantitative way. We might want to do parameter optimization in order to see whether or not we can improve our model. But we haven't taught you those tools yet, so we'll have to save those for tomorrow's tutorials. Right now, what we'll do is we're going to compare our model against an alternative model.